Hello, I'm Jeanne Caldwell, and welcome to In His Presence. Well, this is Thanksgiving week, and this is when everybody's cooking the turkey and the dressing, and families are getting together and just being thankful that they have a family. You know, there are a lot of folks out there that don't have family. But let me just say this. If you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior, you have a Father. And He will be a father to you, He'll be a mother to you, He'll be a brother to you, a sister to you, He'll be everything to you, because He's Lord. So what I want to do is I want to sing a song about Come Expecting Jesus. It's about communion. And then after the song, I will do a short teaching on how we need to be thankful, and then we will have communion. I haven't had communion with you in some time, and so I'm looking forward to that. But first, let's sing this song, Come Expecting Jesus.
I'm expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. I come expecting to receive His mercy and His grace. When I eat the bread and drink the wine, it will be a holy moment in time. I come expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. I come expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. I come expecting to receive His mercy and His grace. When I eat the bread and drink the wine, it will be a holy moment in time. I come expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. The table is spread. Here waits the wine. Here waits the bread. This passage of hope. Expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. I come expecting to receive His mercy and His grace. When I eat the bread and drink the wine, it will be a holy moment. I come expecting Jesus to meet me in this place. Remember the price that He paid. This beauty. Survey I come expecting Jesus to meet me in this place, in this
Well, please stay tuned because I'll be right back after this short break and we'll have communion.
Stir up your spirit and refresh your soul with Jeanne Caldwell's album, Colors, with songs like Didn't Think It Could Be.
I didn't think it could be till it happened to me.
And My Father.
I want to be more like Him, more like my Father. Him every day.
You're sure to be refreshed every time you listen. Colors is just $14 plus shipping and handling. To get your copy, visit our website at vtntv.com or call 1-888-641-3375.
Welcome back. Well, as you see, I have the emblems here, and we are going to partake of communion. And if you don't have grape juice, if you don't have the bread, you know, you can substitute it with water if need be and a piece of bread. I know that the main idea is for you to receive His blood and His body that He shed for you, not only for the remission of your sins, but for the healing of your body. And I know I've shared from time to time about when Happy and our son and I used to travel on the road, we were always in churches, and so therefore there was never communion served while we were there. And that is one thing that I truly missed, is having communion. And I remember one time I was at my sister's in Annandale, Virginia, and one morning I got up and I was listening to the radio preachers, and I don't even know who this preacher was. But as I was making up the bed, he said, "Now for the shut-ins and for those that can't go to church and for those of you that I have communion with from time to time," he said, "if you'll get your emblems, we will be serving communion in just a moment." Well, I went running into the kitchen, and all I could get was a glass of water and a piece of bread. And my sister Elizabeth said, "Well, what are you doing?" I said, "Nothing. I'll tell you in a minute." And I went running back into the bedroom, and I sat down on the floor beside the bed, listening to the radio. And when he came back, he read the scriptures about communion, and I partook of communion with the water and the bread, but I want you to know God honored it. And I just felt His presence just really go all over me. He ministered so beautifully to me, His love. And so we need to be thankful for what Jesus did for us. And let me mention this too. We have a choice this Thanksgiving as the family gathers together of how we're going to act and how we're going to react. We should have an attitude of gratitude, as they say, for Thanksgiving, because there are a lot of people in this world that we see on television. We know the things that are happening round about us in these other countries where people are actually suffering. They don't have the blessings that we have. So we need to be thankful this Thanksgiving for what God has done for us. We need to be thankful for His faithfulness to us. He's so faithful if we will just trust Him, if we will just spend time in fellowship with Him and in praying and reading His Word. When we do that, He's so faithful to meet us. And I tell you, like that song says, you come expecting Jesus. Well, I fully expect Jesus to be in this service today. This is a program, but it's also a service, because when you go to church, you're administered the emblems of the bread and the body and the blood and the wine, and we're going to do it on a television program. But you know, it doesn't make any difference where you have communion. You could have it at home yourself. You wouldn't have to bother with having it on television or in church. You could have this time with Jesus alone, and it would be a blessing to you. In Colossians 4 and 2, the Lord tells us to continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. So we are to continue in prayer and be very watchful in the same with thanksgiving. Paul was telling us that we need a spirit or attitude of thanksgiving. And you know, when we look at the life of Jesus, it's very evident that a spirit of thanksgiving was very important to Him. At the resurrection of Lazarus, John wrote in chapter 11, verse 41, and Jesus lifted up His eyes and said, Father, I thank Thee that Thou hast heard me. He thanked the Father for hearing him pray. And then in Matthew 11, 25, when Jesus was feeding the multitude, He said, and He took the seven loaves, and gave thanks. So we see that on another occasion, He gave thanks to the Father as He took the seven loaves. He thanked God for it. Shows us we need to thank God for our food. On another occasion, when Jesus was teaching His disciples, He paused to pray. And He said, I thank Thee, O Father. So we see that giving thanks to God was very important to Jesus. Well, if it's important for Jesus, it's important for me. It's important for thee. It's important for us to learn to be thankful to God for everything that He does for us, not take anything for granted. And I, for one, choose this Thanksgiving to be one that's filled with a grateful, thankful heart. Number one, for the United States of America and for the blessings that we have. And you may be saying, well, have you looked to the left and have you looked to the right? Do you have on blinders? Do you know what's happening in our United States of America? I know there are a lot of things that are going on, and I pray for our president. I pray for all those in authority and for our governor. I pray for those in authority according to 1 Timothy 2, 1 through 3. But let me tell you something. We are a Christian nation. Whether there's Christians in this, some people are Christians, some people aren't. But it makes no difference. We are a Christian nation. In God we trust. And you find churches just about on every corner or every mile in every city, you'll find churches. So we're a Christian nation. You need to be thankful for that. And pray for those that you know are lost or backslidden. But thank God for America. That's one thing you can be thankful for. Thank Him that you have food to eat. Thank Him that you have family. There are many of those that don't have family. You know, I'm thinking right now of the missionary Jim Zirkel that was recently killed in a plane crash. He had Living Water Teaching Center in Guatemala. We've been there. We ministered at his teaching center. A precious man of God doing a great work for God. And just this past month, when Mitch hit, the hurricane hit, and all the damage that was done, he was flying in and had to circle the airport for a couple of hours. When he did, he actually ran out of gas, and by the time he did his forced landing, he could not make it on the runway, and when he tried to go back up again to circle, he went into the side of a mountain, and it killed seven men that were aboard. He was one of them. His son was one of them, and his son-in-law. Me, I'm thinking about his wife that has to spend the rest of her life without a husband, without a son, and her daughter that's spending time, he'll have this Christmas, this Thanksgiving actually, alone, without a husband, without a father, and without a brother. So, you know, there are a lot of tragedies that are out there. So thank God for your family members, and don't take them for granted. Don't take them for granted. Now, if you will get your emblems, we are going to have communion. And let me just say these few things about communion. This is not just a religious observance. It's an actual connecting with the power of Jesus Christ. It's a very powerful force. It's what Jesus did for us 2,000 years ago. And we need to always remember that. In Matthew 26, 26 through 28, this is when Jesus instituted the Lord's Supper at Passover. And verse 26 says, "And as they were eating," that was he and his disciples, "Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body.' And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, 'Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins.'" And I tell you what's so wonderful, in the Old Testament, when the lamb, you know, was sacrificed, a lamb without spot or wrinkle or anything, or blotch, that blood was, you know, shed, and it was also spread upon the altar. And they had to eat all of it. The priest and the Levites had to eat all of it. And anything that was left had to be burned completely up. And in the Old Testament, that blood just covered their sins from one year to the next. But Jesus, when he shed his blood as the perfect Lamb of God, one without spot or blotch or wrinkle or anything, he shed his for many for the remission of sins. Once you're born again, everything that you've ever done in your past is totally done away with. God loves you so much, he's always trying to hide your sin. He's always trying to hide it. And when you get born again, he covers it. That's something to be thankful for. So the church has centered its attention on the wine, actually, as an emblem of Jesus' blood that was shed for sin. And, you know, we thank God for that and praise him that he's delivered us from sin. But that's only half of communion. The other half is the bread, which is the emblem of Jesus' body that was broken for us. And when you read, and you can, on your own time, read Isaiah 53, 4 through 5, where it talks about Jesus, where absolutely he covered every area of man's existence when he gave himself as a sacrifice for our sins. He took the sins of man upon him. Now let's go to 1 Corinthians, the first chapter, not the first chapter, the 11th chapter, starting with verse 23. And when we get there, I want you to turn there with me, and we will partake of communion together. In Jesus' name. And Father, I thank you now that as we partake of this communion, that first of all, as we see in verse 28, "But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup." But it says to examine yourself. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep or die prematurely. So if we judge ourselves, we will not be judged, and you won't be judged by God. Satan is the one that comes to rob, to steal, and to kill, and to judge you. But if you will examine yourself, if you will judge yourself, ask God to forgive you where you've sinned in any area. I don't care if it's sin, sickness, drugs, worry, strife, old habits, in any area. Resentment, bitterness, offense, whatever it is, ask God to forgive you. Judge yourself, and you will not be judged. Same way with the body bread. When you partake of that bread, receive the healing for your body that Jesus paid a price for. It's not only for your sins to be remitted, but it's for your body to be healed of whatever is attaching itself to you. And you just, when you're examining yourself, ask God also, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to deliver me from this disease that's in my body. And because you paid the price for me to have healing, I receive it now as I partake of communion. I receive your healing in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, because it's for you. He paid the price for you. For you not only to be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, saved, have eternal life, but for you to live this life on this earth free from all kinds of sickness and disease and all the wiles of the devil that would come against you. He's there for you to help you through all of these things if you will just examine yourself and partake of this Lord's Supper from time to time. Even, like I say, you might want to do it at home. You might want to. I've known of some people that get their Bible and they get before the Lord and they get their grape juice and they get their bread, their unleavened bread or whatever that they have at home, and they will go before the Lord for either healing in their body or whatever area that they want to talk to Him about. They have communion with Him. They worship Him, and then they literally partake of this communion. And God honors it. God honors it. Now, what I want to do right now is I want to read these scriptures, and I want, if you've got your emblems now, we'll partake of these emblems. And you can open your Bible and read these with me too, if you will. Chapter 11, verse 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He gave thanks. He brake it and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you. Thank you for your body. It was broken for me. And I thank you that healing is mine. In Jesus' name, I thank you for it. After the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. You can take the cup now and drink it in remembrance of him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till He come. Praise be to God for the privilege of partaking of the Lord's Supper and being grateful and being thankful for what Jesus Christ has done for us. You know, God loved us so much that He sent His only begotten Son. But did you know that Jesus was willing to come? He didn't have to, but He loved us so much. He not only came and lived with us on this earth for 33 years, but He gave His life on a cruel cross that we may have everlasting life. And I'm thankful for that, and I am grateful. Well, I want each and every one of you to have a very blessed Thanksgiving. I just pray that the Spirit of the Lord will be upon your household, and every one of you will rejoice in the Lord, for He is your strength. And remember that in His presence is fullness of joy. Bye-bye.
With a simple prayer, "Fill my cup, Lord," Jeanne Caldwell opened the door to the love of God to overflow in her life and experience God's supernatural ability. She shares intimate details from her walk with God in this delightful read, "My Supernatural Encounters with God." With practical illustrations, Jeanne explains how she has come to know the love of God in a more personal way, revealing the love that God has for all of us through her story. This book, "My Supernatural Encounters with God," has been made available to you for $5.99 plus shipping and handling. To order your copy, call us at 1-888-641-3375 or log on to our website, www.vtntv.com. Learn how you can experience supernatural encounters with God and have your cup overflowing with the love of God in your life today. Thank you for joining us today for In His Presence. You can write Jeanne Caldwell at Post Office Box 26207, Little Rock, Arkansas 72221, or email her at jeannecaldwell@vtntv.com. To order a DVD of today's program, call 1-888-641-3375 and ask for the offer number on the screen. Join us next time as we meet in His presence.